Hey, the train is rolling on the campus of Utah Valley University. This is Mike Clapier, along with my partner, Sam Allen. Welcome to the PE building, where it's another night of Division I wrestling on the campus, Utah Valley Wolverines. Tonight, we welcome Pac-12. Cardinals are in the house from Stanford. Last contest, we went against Northern Colorado. Sam, you saw it. What was great about that?
Well, I'll tell you exactly what was great. We had a shutout victory. This is a Western Conference opponent that we had come into town. We've always had good matchups with them. Northern Colorado's having a down year. That didn't discredit us, discredit UVU at all. We came hard. We came finishing matches, and we came away with a shutout victory. It felt great. The fans were totally enthused. It was an amazing matchup.
We're excited to be here. We hope you're with us as well. Join us. We'll be back. Mike Clapier, Sam Allen, welcome to Utah Valley Wrestling.
Wolverine Wrestling.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
Here we go at 125. This could be a great match, one of the better technical matches of the night, because Evan Silver, redshirt freshman for Stanford, is out of Blair Academy. Always a great team, always great competitive wrestlers, Blair Academy private school back in New Jersey.
We had Arizona State went last week right after they dueled us. They went up and dueled Stanford, and they were talking about Silver having a pretty tough match against the Arizona State wrestler, and I had to say, our guy, Jade, he pinned him in the first round.
Well, you always got to wrestle the match. One of my good mentors, Sam Arishida, who I coached with for a lot of years, he always said, you can say what you
nice
want.
Shot.
There's a nice, beautiful shot in there, right? Nice counter, nice switch back. Not quite there. Got to settle the toes in. There it is. Stanford didn't agree with that one. Picking it up. Hips were still out. I think that's an arguable call. I know there's a conversation about that out-of-bounds call, because on the book we say if it lands there, it looks right, you got to call it. But if it were the same position, and that was a good example, if it were the same position in the middle of the mat, you'd let that continue. There's no control there. The whole game in folk style, which is what we're wrestling, used to be called collegiate, now we're wrestling folk style. The key element here is it's a matter of control. My job at this point, our job for Rouser right now, is to control what's happening on the mat and work towards a fall. Work to take control on top and turn Silver. Silver's job is to get out from underneath that and restart neutral or get a reversal and get back. But it's a control game as opposed to the Olympic sport, where you see more of a throw and a motion game.
Yeah, some exposure. I'll tell you, I think the call, why most questionable right there on the edge of the mat, was Jade reached across, grabbed both legs and gave two, and immediately
Silver was able to get a little scramble. So coach was going, hey, wait, it wasn't quite two yet.
So you're saying because they were out of bounds and he did that motion, that then secured the takedown,
exactly.
And then because we're out of bounds as opposed to in, the reaction time isn't the same.
Exactly.
It's not judged the same.
Yeah.
There's always this element of reaction time. If I take you down and you can react before I settle in that control position, then the points are not scored. So the referee is not only judging and watching for safety of the wrestlers, but he's also making sure that the motion takes place beyond. Nice release. That was sweet.
That was
nice release, reset, and take control again there. Rouser comfortably taking care of things right now, although he's not turning yet. Sometimes as a wrestler, you've wrestled Division I, wrestled part of this program. How much does it matter? How important is this grinding and getting that energy down so that later in the match, what I might not be able to do in the first period, I can do in the second?
Well, even if you watch Jade's fantastic at this. Constant pressure, constant heavy, keeping heavy on top. If you watch Evan Silver here, he's having a hard time even just getting up onto his knees. And the few times he's had a good explosion off the bottom, Jade's picked him right back up, yeah. Brought him right back down, or released for a second and athletic move, and he was right back up on top. Evan's doing a good job here with a stand-up, but there goes Jade, brings him right back down, and immediately you watch him just start grinding over that shoulder, pulling that arm underneath. That's some good technique there.
Well, and I think that confidence, you know, success breeds confidence, and so as we're going in, it was a huge shot to the program to do a good job. There we finished the first round. We got a two-point score. Rouser secured a nice takedown, controlled things on the match. Utah Valley, we are in the down position, so our job is to get away, get out of there, either secure an escape or get away for two.
But
nice job standing up.
Nice stand-up. But if you watch here, Jade's doing a good job of getting his weight off of his hands.
Oh,
he's getting
beautiful.
The weight onto his feet.
Nice knee slide. Oh, good job.
Very good job.
Hips came up strong, knee slide, hand control. Also, the hand control takes place after the hips are moved where you want, where sometimes the high school kids, they'll try to fight the hands before they get that secure hip position.
Yeah.
That was a great example. Go back and watch that. Rewind that when you're watching this later. That was just textbook. Of course, Greg and our coaches, Irkeen and Justin, fantastic technicians we have in the room.
UVU is extremely lucky. They got two world-class coaches. Irkeen, a lot of people don't realize the Russian in our room. We got a little Russian connection. And
European champion.
Very, very, very talented. And then we got another world-class coach with Justin Reese, Olympic.
Nice shot here by Silver. See if the counter is in deep. That's pretty good. Oh, he did it.
Comes away with it.
Got around the corner. Got in deep again. Rouser was able to stop. So we're tied up. We're at 2-2, although Rouser's been able to put 2 minutes of riding time. So there's a little advantage for us there. Right now, we need another escape. We need to score some points.
Notice
right
the pressure. The pressure's going forward. Weight is on Jade's hands. That's a good riding position if I'm the top man. Won't get very heavy on, very, very heavy.
And it's hard to see that when you're not initiated if you don't know the sport. But watch Silver's toes. Watch how hard his feet are digging into the mat.
Just
that's the pressure that he's putting onto the front of those shoulders, and that's to keep Rouser on his heat, on his hands, so he can't get the hips underneath. Now he's got a little bit of a break. Gonna come down, fight that hand on the hip. Silver lets that go. Rouser now into that position, needs to stand.
Little slow right there at the end for Jade. Would like to see him get an escape there.
Well, we're 2-2 going in. We do have a riding time advantage. Silver was able to whittle that down just a little bit. We're neutral, like that's a place we want to be. We got an escape. That's a 3-2 score, so we're up by one, and riding time is our advantage. Now Rouser can make this thing work on his feet. And he's solid there. Great Greco and freestyle background.
Yeah, fantastic. And one of the keys as we've watched Jade this season is when he's able to score an early takedown and really grind in that first round, that's where he's explosive. So it'll be interesting to see him push through here, keep his feet and hands moving, keep his techniques crisp and sharp. Nice snap down there. We'll look for him to open up and score his takedown. A little short.
I'd like to see a little more offense out of Rouser. He seems to be kind of sitting back and watching a little more. Greg's getting at him now. Greg's saying, come on, let's make the motion work our way and get in on the shot once we've created that turn. Watch what Rouser's doing. How much battle is it to get the other guy out of position?
Oh, yeah. I mean, when you're wrestling, getting a guy to step,
move. Tough one to finish. Double leg. Sorry to step on what you're saying. That.
Well, yeah. A shot like that, not a lot of motion, not a lot of movement there. So a short shot to just grab some legs.
So what we want to do is to get Stanford to turn a little bit so we can shorten that distance. There's another a nice shot by Silver.
Switch.
Oh, that hits him up. Now we got a score here. We got 45 seconds remaining. We've effectively got a tie match, except in 5 seconds, riding time's going to switch for us, so we need to get out of there right now. Come on, Jake. 30 seconds.
With his head, you know, he's got his head down, but we got Stanford. He's kind of riding back on. Oh, there he goes. He goes
seconds.
Out to the side here.
Why is it we want to see him coming up? Why is he not able to come up? Is it the pressure on the hips?
Got a lot of pressure, yeah.
10 seconds.
But you always want to look at this, and we got short time here. You always want to look at where your head's at. If you got to get your knees underneath you, your head up. Just a nice job by Silver.
It's a nice win by Stanford. Stay with us. You're at the campus of Utah Valley University.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
Hi, my name is Tony. I'm a student with UVU Automotive, and this is my classroom. At UVU, you can graduate with a diploma and a resume.
We're at 133 pounds. Chasen Tolbert, a sophomore with an 8-6 record, is out there wrestling Alex Manley, also a sophomore. And we'll see if we can get ourselves on the board here.
Chasen's wrestled tough. He's kind of gone back and forth with Val Rouser, one of the Rouser twins, being in and out this season. Chasen's done a great job of stepping in and actually wrestling quite well. He's 8-6 on the year. One-on-one in our duels.
There again, we're sparring, keeping distance, trying to control the head, want to get a shot, want to set that shot up in such a way that I don't have to travel the full distance between my body and his. I want to try to get him to turn the corner if possible and then progress into some kind of a shot, whether it's one leg or two. Don't see a lot of throws in folk style or college wrestling. Not like we do in the freestyle in the Greco world.
Not nearly as much. Chasen here working with this Russian, though. Seems to feel comfortable there. Clears off.
Nice two-on-one combination now coming back
comes
in.
Over. Fake shot by Manley. You see, as you battle here, Chasen feel comfortable with this. And a nice shot there.
Beautiful. Nice shot in on caught.
touches that arm, he holds on to that arm, there's a lot of offense he can score out of that. Unfortunately, just let it go.
That puts us up 2.0 for scored takedown, 1 minute, 18 seconds remaining. First round, we're in the second match, Utah Valley versus Stanford on the campus in the PE building at Utah Valley University. Now working for that fall, trying to get that.
Again, a trap arm, trap tricep right there. Does a good job of powering out of that. Going to get weight forward on his hands here. He's back on his hip. Comes way into a crab right here.
Again, we're looking for control. Utah Valley in green, where our job is to turn. Our job is to score some points. Trying to move him into a tilt situation. It's almost there. Doing a good job with it. Almost there. There's the count. One, two. There's a two count. Picks up two near fall points. That gives us a four-point advantage. Nice move there. Nice tight control of hips and moved him into that cheap tilt.
Yeah, worked it. Worked and it worked for him.
20 seconds remaining. Tolbert trying to get another turn. The near fall criteria comes into effect if one shoulder is down and the other shoulder is less than a 45-degree angle to the mat, and that's what the official is moving into position to make that adjudication. That's a big word for us today.
I'm learning.
Judgment.
End of the first period. Chasen's up 4-0. Nice job. Takedown and a good cheap tilt to score.
Choice
two
goes
fall.
To us. We're giving it back to Stanford. Stanford wants to go into the down position. See if we can work that turn a little bit more.
Chasen was a transfer from Colorado Mesa University, where he wrestled there. Wanted to come to a Division I here in Utah and try his luck and doing a good job here. Back into this crab right again, where this is where he scored this cheap tilt the last round.
Stanford's working a little better, trying to control hands, push back, free himself. Now he needs to get hips away and turn. But Tolbert countered that, stayed tight, stayed close. So Stanford has not been able to get away from us. Now ridden him for 2 minutes and 8 seconds. But we can't just hang on there. We got to be working for that fall. So here again, it's that move him in. Nice little Granby kind of a move.
Well, as I referee also, you know, I always tell guys, listen, if you're hanging around, you're just hanging back there, you're not advancing your position, and that's where I'm going to say, you know, you're slowing. Ooh, a nice cradle.
And right here is where he needs to do that. He had an opportunity to lock his hands and get a cradle situation and then pull that back into a pinning combination. But Stanford's doing a good job fighting it away, and right now we're not. We need to move out, create some story. Now right now we're waiting for Stanford to move. Stanford's waiting for us to move. There's not much action. Official's going to make a call here in a minute about somebody get at it. We're sitting on that back leg a lot. Kind of wondering about how long he's going to let us camp out there. It's good for us. We're controlling the ride. But when does it just be hanging on? 15 seconds remaining.
Chasen's doing a great job of just riding tough.
He's heavy, really controlling it.
Heavy. If he's not heavy on up on his hands and shoulders, he's got him back in a crab ride He's got a dangerous little cheap tilt that he does from there.
Well, Utah Valley in pretty good shape. We got 3 minutes and 30 seconds of riding time, which gives us a point if things stay the same. And we got 4 points in the match. So effectively, we're up by five as we go into the third round. And Utah Valley takes that down position. And got to see if he can get out from underneath that. See what Stanford can do. Second match, Stanford won the first one. Tight match, good close competition. And they are ahead of Utah Valley in the second match, 3-0. Team score.
Chasen, nice job, quick up off his feet. Immediately to his feet, fighting the hand control, and he's out.
There it is.
Nice head snap,
oh,
right to
nice
a shot.
Back into a shot.
You know, I call that chain wrestling. When you put one move into a next move, and so first move, he exploded up. Second move, he's got his hips low. Third, he's fighting hand control. And immediately as he turns out, he's pulling on the head, and he's into a shot. I mean, that's four or five consecutive moves that make you very, very lethal.
The other thing that was nice about that sequence is he got his hips up and in control before he came in to fight hands. Instead of fighting those hands, sometimes we see these younger wrestlers will drop the head, fight hands, battle. He just got his hips under control on his feet where he could move better and move with power, and then took care of the hands, and the result was a three-point turnaround. Now leads 7, and he's piling more riding time in. 1 minute remaining, third round in the second match, Utah Valley versus Stanford.
Now for us, we want to make sure we control the rest of this match, draw this lead out even longer. For those of you listening, an 8-point victory is different than a 7-6-5-4-3-2-1 point victory. You score 14 points instead of a 3 for what's called a decision. A major decision is 8 or more points.
And that was the difference for us when we wrestled Arizona State, because actually we won 5 matches, they won 5 matches.
Exactly.
But they won their 5 by 3-point decisions. We won our 5 by 3 pins, a major, which is a 4-pin win, and a technical foul, which is a 15-point advantage, which scores 5 team points.
Nice lock up here.
See if he can pull that back.
His cradle position.
See if he can move that back. Short
time
seconds.
Here. Let's see if we can pull something out. We'll get those bonus points. I broke that lock, so we got a 10 seconds left. We want to hold on to him, though.
Well,
nice job there.
I think Chase did a nice job of controlling things. It wasn't an exciting match to watch, but we were in great shape all the way through. Watch right here. Nice motion, good step, good level change, hips drop, big step forward, and controlled Stanford's far arm, which puts him in that control. That was the first takedown of 2 points. He ends up scoring 8. That's a major decision. So we go up 1. It's 4-3. With Utah Valley in front of Stanford on the campus of Utah Valley University. Come back, we got Division I wrestling right now.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest growing, and most dynamic universities.
Dawn is breaking at Utah Valley University. 33,000 students are descending on campus. What are they after? Knowledge? Opportunity? They might be pursuing an MBA, an automotive certificate, or a bachelor's degree in philosophy. But despite their different paths, they share a common understanding.
$5. UVU t-shirt so you can impress the ladies, $25. iPod Nano, $120. A degree from UVU so you can afford your own car someday. Priceless. For everything else, they're student loans.
Glad that you've joined us here on the campus as we watch at 141 pounds when Avery Gardner wrestles for Utah Valley. His opponent, Josh Lauderdale, a sophomore for Stanford. Nice shot in. And Avery scores 2 to get things started.
You know, Avery has developed very well. Started here, did a year, then an LDS mission, has come home. Physically matured, he's very, you know, much stronger. He was wrestling between 133 and 141, and now has found a good home at 141. He's a good size there, strong, and developed very, very well. He's having a good year.
Out of Boise, Idaho, a Centennial wrestler, Avery has given us that ability to be strong in that 41 pound as he's grown into it, as you mentioned there, Sam, as he's grown in, working an arm bar, trying to get a turn going on there. What is Avery's strength? Is it in the room, work ethic, natural ability? What is his strength?
You know, our last broadcast, I mentioned this too. Avery is extremely hardworking. He's not just hardworking in the room. He's dedicated in the classroom too. He's very smart. He's a pre-med student. He's the type of guy that you're like, oh, he he'd go to Stanford.
He could. He's got that arm bar in, got the wrist trapped, up in there strong with the bar. Great shot from our crew. I'd like to thank our digital media students and their crew here today producing this for us. A great opportunity here. If you are watching this and you think you want to learn the skills of broadcast media, come and get involved with us here at Utah Valley. The digital media production takes care of a lot of great things right here on campus. As Avery clamps down, that's why I said clampus, it's not campus, but Avery's clamping down on that far arm bar, trying to come into that far half, and hasn't turned it yet, but it's sure wearing. Burns a lot of energy on Stanford's behalf. He's got his hips up, trying to move away, but Avery changes to that front lock, trying to put some kind of a cradle together. That didn't work. Now Stanford trying to bring his hips up, Avery working again.
Doing a nice job of just keeping constant pressure from one move to another, from a bar arm series to a half to a tilt here.
And we should be able to get into some kind of a turn here. He's got a good pressure on the hip. Look, we'd want to come up onto the head next, if in fact he can do it. Come up, push pressure on the head, and push the head away. That would be, I would think, the next position he wants. Stanford's down low in that, trying to scoot his hips away. His next move would be to try to get in and catch a leg. He's not getting that done. And Avery is working on that tilt position, trying
right
to secure.
There
he goes to the head. That's what we're talking about. And we run out of time.
You know, in a position like that, you run to that power half or a shoulder hug situation where you're able to just hug that shoulder, keep your hips in your chest tight to his back, hopefully score some near fall there.
Obviously felt that the situation or the pressure wasn't just where he wanted it to be, and then he finally got there. And with the way he had the hips bound, he was going to be able to turn those shoulders, but time ran out. So we begin the second round. Avery takes a down position. He's leading with 2-point takedown initially, trying to get hip separation and get away. And Stanford doing a good job keeping weight up on in that crab ride scenario. Now here, Avery doing a good job trying to get that separation we talked about, trying to catch. There he got hips away. That's a good thing for us. Now he's up, trying to take hand control. Got hips up. Now he needs to get the foot back on, keep hand control. Oh, ooh, nice.
Nice. Spladle.
That was sweet.
Just tripped him down.
Tripped him down with his arm and hipped into it, but gained control back. Stanford lost control. We now have control. That gains 2 points in wrestling. And now Stanford's got to fight to get away from a pinning combination because we've got some pressure on the back at this point. That was a nice move. Now we're back to the same kind of pressure. Crab ride, I'm reaching far. Stanford trying to gain that separation, trying to work that thing. He's got to get his hips away. Hips under and away at the same time. And then Adrian adjusts back and wins that fight for that position right there.
Again, if you watch this position, Avery's hips constantly pushing and applying pressure.
Yep.
Constantly on top, and that's where you really see what separates a good wrestler from a great wrestler is how he's able to ride on top.
Now on the right side, he's got that arm trapped. He's got a good grip on the arm. He's trying to get underneath and get a bar. They're going to call a stalemate on that one. Because it wasn't going anywhere. Avery was trying to get up on top, get some pressure to the head. Wasn't able to do that. So new start, 4-point lead, 21 seconds remaining in the second round. Gardner in front, Utah Valley leading Stanford 4-3. And this is just the third match. A lot of wrestling to come.
Avery right into the spiral riding position. Gets weight up on the hands. Extends the body
it's
so he
exhausting.
Can't stay compact.
It's exhausting to battle that. Well, Stanford tried to do a little roll. That didn't work. Couldn't get it going. And time. All right, round three. What's Stanford thinking? He takes down. What's he got to do?
Well, he's been rode out. I'm not sure I feel about the choice. He's been rode out for 3 minutes and 30 seconds. He chooses down, but Avery actually says, hey, I elected for the neutral position. That's where the referee says, oh, we'll just start you straight up. Awards Stanford the point, so Avery gets a start up on his feet. I think that's smart, too. Avery understood me. Hey, I spent 3 minutes and 30 seconds attempting to turn him. Let's see what I can do on my feet now.
Well, you can get 2, plus you can take a guy to his back easier from your feet sometimes, especially once we've amassed 3 minutes and 30 seconds or any time, so we'll see what we can get done up here. Kind of a stalemate going to come here if something doesn't improve.
Avery's got him extended down on his hip. Got to get a high hip to break this lock.
And that didn't happen. Stalemate there. We're going to put him back up.
And Josh Lauderdale there from Stanford. He shot a shot and locked up and held on for dear life. I'm not sure how much he was really finishing that. He got it. I mean, it was a decent shot, but not a lot of finish on it.
David Avery doing a good job with the down block. Now trying to get control on the head and the tie. Maintain that hole. What's the battle? What's that battle in control? There we go. Nice shot.
Shot there. Straight down the legs, collapsed them together, drove through for a nice 2-point takedown.
Kind of caught him off balance. That's that setup, because he actually caught Stanford off balance a little bit. Stanford, instead of down blocking straight on, was actually a little off the corner, and so as Avery pushed into him, it almost looked like he fell off his base. That one wasn't hard to earn. Avery in comfortably lead now, 6-1, amassing more riding time as he tries to work that turn. We need to get a major. We've got to build some more points. We need major or even a fall.
Well, again, darn it.
Now we let him go for one. We can get two. Trade one for two. We'll do that the rest of the time. 23 seconds remaining in the match. We got a 4-point advantage.
Well, this is again a good scenario where, you know, things happen a little different. We're able to ride and get some turns. We amount that 8-point major decision victory.
There's a nice shot that Stanford got in deep on the single leg, but Avery's doing a good job keeping hip down, controlling that scenario, and then we're out of time. That's a good solid win.
Nice job for Avery Gardner.
Not fancy, but good, and we'll take it. We'll take a W on any side of the page. That's Avery Gardner walking away. Good shot of Coach Williams. Glad to see that happen. Puts the team score up to 7-3. And we are now ready to wrestle at 149 pounds. This could be one of the better contests. In fact, should be. Senior versus senior, 2 solid wrestlers.
Timmy Boone has been, one of Stanford's better wrestlers. Ryan Mango was an NCAA qualifier last year. A Pac-12 All-American and a Pac-12 champion. He took a redshirt year this year, and so
nice shot. Nice rechange of the single. Pushing just needs to finish it. That was a great counter off of Boone's shot. That was a great job, Josh. I'm trying to finish that inbounds. There we go, right there.
Nice.
That's 2-point
takedown.
Good job, Josh. There's 2. That's a good start.
Timmy Boone, senior, being a leader on the team. Comment I was making, though, is we have 2 seniors on the team taking a leadership role. Josh Wilson, also a senior. Nice shot. Nice counter shot and takedown there.
That was good wrestling. 2 minutes 18. We're just getting going in this first round. Is Josh starting to come into his own? Is that confidence starting to be there? How's he wrestling?
Well, Josh has wrestled very well. Even, you know, I would say career-wise, this year had a great showing in the Midlands Championship. He placed there. That's arguably just as tough, if not more difficult, than the national championships that we hold. There's fantastic wrestlers that come out to that. But Josh dealt with some injuries, and he's had a little ups and downs, but right now is the time we want to see Josh just continue to build, and had a good match last week, had a good match against Arizona. So again, one of the keys to UVU success and Josh's success is just to keep building off of the momentum that we have.
I think he's feeling good at the weight.
I think so too.
His energy is starting to be there consistently. And that's a key element. That's a key situation to be able to go hard for 7 minutes or eight longer if you have to.
Well, Josh is built well for wrestling. He's strong as an ox, short and it's, you know, low to the ground. He's hard to shoot on. He's has some great technique.
He's competitive too.
Oh, listen, I've wrestled with Josh. And I think wrestlers, you know, this bodes well for almost any wrestler that are ultra competitive.
Yeah.
Josh is extremely competitive, and actually, I think that's one of his strong suits. He loves to win, he loves to compete, he loves to work hard, and he's a definite leader on UVU's team.
34 seconds remaining in the first round. Josh has secured that first takedown, and he's doing a good job of controlling this situation. Trying to pop him over. Don't get too far. Comes back. That's good. Boone tried to recoup that. Recover a little bit. Didn't work. Josh was able to scoop hips. Red getting a warning now. He's got to build more. He's got to take more risk. There's Josh trying to work the turn. Got legs in, controlling that. 7 seconds remaining.
You know, one thing that you see a lot of UVU's wrestlers doing is they got a good series that goes from a wrist ride to a bar arm to a leg ride, and it's a good series that they're working because it keeps constant pressure.
Like Josh's attitude, he steps up, looks at Coach. Coach says, get down there and get out. I like the way he signals it. It just looked confident, like I'm going there and I'll be out in a minute. So hang on, folks. Here we go. Second round. Hips up, control hands now. Yeah. Boone's got a leg in. Josh got to clear that. Battling hands for right now. As soon as he breaks that clear, he's out. Boone's just hanging. There's one for us. That's stalling on Boone, and he's not doing a thing.
Well, the responsibility of a top wrestler, especially when you get up to the feet on a feet position, is to return the wrestler to the mat.
One us.
Nice job by Josh.
That's a good two-point
feeling the pressure
pickup.
Change. Boone was dropping to a leg to try and just hang on that and perhaps collect both legs. Josh felt that coming. Boom, jumped right out.
Yeah, we come to our feet, and the wrestler who has the offensive position has a responsibility to get you back to the mat. And if he doesn't do that, then he's stalling. And that was a nice call by the official. NCAA certified officials here with us, obviously. We're D1 after all. And he did a nice job, very relaxed. I like the way this guy calls things. Right solid there, if it's there, he calls it. There's a nice job.
Nice around. Chain again.
Oh, sweet, right into the, no.
Great job.
What did he hit?
Josh.
There were three skills right there. That was nice.
It was really good. There was a shot by Boone. He stopped it, pulled the head, shot. That shot wasn't there. He changed it to a double leg and finished double leg. I mean, that was a fantastic job by Josh.
It was three skills right there, just nice. All off of a counter off of Boone's shot. That was
again,
excellent.
Josh is heavy up into the shoulder with that wrist ride, looking to pull that out across the back to a bar arm series. Tilt, there's a lot of options here.
Now Greg's got something in mind. I'd like to know what Greg just said. Look at the smile.
Yeah, he's got a big old grin on his face.
He's got something going. He's doing a good job. He's doing a good job. I think that the strategy that they had to wrestle Boone, because Boone is an excellent wrestler, and we're dominating him. We're dominating the ride. We're dominating the takedowns. And I think that the strategy that they had, I'd love to ask Greg after the match, but it seems to me the strategy they had going into this thing is Josh executing it just as he should. And I think that's a nice statement for Josh's ability. Nice change there.
Right here, Josh has got to work up.
There's one. I don't like giving away with 2 seconds, but there's one on his side. And it's just a good example of Josh Wilson being able to really work the skills and hone his ability. He's been doing it for years and years now. He's a senior in the program, but here you see it. He's
right
working the pressure.
Here. He lines up here. We're going to do a little replay. I think we decided not to.
That's all right. We'll get to it back to it again. Good job. Good job keeping us right in the match. But I really like what I see Josh doing. A little bit of a, you know, got away from it a second there. But he's in good shape. Coming back now.
Risk
let's
right
see if
here.
We can get the turn. Maybe we'll just go back and work our feet for a little bit.
Risk right here again. That gets very, I mean, if you look at this position, you know, whether you're a high school wrestler or not, you look and you go, hey, how much pressure does he have? He's not covering his hips. There's so much pressure. Josh, if you look, he's on his toes, and he's driving. Yeah. All the pressure is just going right down there into Timmy Boone's shoulder.
Great shot.
Makes it very hard for him to move.
Great shot, cameras. Look at his legs. Look at how much pressure, how much strain there is on his leg. There's another stall call. This Stanford kid is not getting at it. Now we're up. That's one more for Stanford. So we're 7-2. Stanford's been hit twice for stalling.
Yeah.
2 points.
2 points after that.
58 seconds remaining.
Exchange. Josh can turn it up. Boone's been nice outside shot there.
But we've been able to score twice off those shots with the counters working well. So we'll see if Josh can get in on that. Keep the hip down. What's important here for Josh? Got to control the head. Got to keep Boone's head buried.
Well, do you see how he's keeping his head pinned with his hips right on top? He wants to pull that elbow. He'll break that lock and kick his hips over. And see how much he stretched him out here? He's got to stretch him out again. He'll pull that lock.
As soon as he steps over, it's coming. He'll be there. As soon as Josh steps over and secures the hips, got to step behind, he'll have it. Not quite yet. Boone's still got a hand back. It's almost there.
There, I think that's
it. Boom, there you go. There's 2 points. Nice job. 13 seconds remaining.
Got to ride him tough here, though, for that major decision victory.
Yeah, I can't let him go. We've got an 8-point win right now.
Four
seconds.
Three,
come on, Josh. Hang on.
Two,
keep
one.
Him solid, Josh. That a boy.
Nice. Nice job, Josh.
Major win.
Great.
That's good
great,
wrestling.
Great job.
That's good wrestling. That's what we're talking about in having the ability for Utah Valley to have the confidence to go with these good guys.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
Dawn is breaking at Utah Valley University. 33,000 students are descending on campus. What are they after? Knowledge? Opportunity? They might be pursuing an MBA, an automotive certificate, or a bachelor's degree in philosophy. But despite their different paths, they share a common understanding.
Hi, my name is Tony. I'm a student with UVU Automotive, and this is my classroom. At UVU, you can graduate with a diploma and a resume.
Back, we just started. We are at 157 pounds, and one of our twins, Chase Cuthbertson, redshirt freshman, is here on the mat against Kyle Meyer, a junior representing Stanford. 243, just into the match. You are on the campus, the PE building at Utah Valley, where we have Division I, the Pac-12 versus the Western Wrestling Conference. And we're excited to be here. Sam Allen, along with Michael Clapier, and we're glad you're with us.
Little bit of flurry there, front headlock. So you know we're going to reset, come back up on our feet here. Wrestling so much about position, weaving on their feet here with our hands, where we're placing our hands, where we're pulling our neck, some pushes and pulls. It's like a chess match of sorts.
That was a nice job, Jack, dropping the head. Or Chase puts good pressure there as he moves forward. Now he needs to score from in that position. Wants to make sure that he controls the elbow and doesn't get in trouble, and then either backs out for a restart or progresses further. Once chooses the restart position.
Ooh, nice snap there, and Chase actually ended up clear on his butt.
That's a good example of the amount of pressure, because Meyer had so much pressure on his head that when he got a little out of balance, it was like, whoa, I better scramble and not get this thing going south on me. And he did that. Good.
Nice athletic move by Chase, not giving up anything big there. We come back in the middle, and again, we're at this chess match with a hand fight and head fight.
When you get talking to athletes from the coast, these guys are obviously the San Francisco area, Palo Alto. What does our altitude affect wrestlers from Stanford?
You know, Stanford's coming at us from sea level, and I will tell you, there are universities that are higher than Utah Valley, just a few of them. But our elevation here, I think it's a real advantage. We got our some oxygenated blood. Hang on to those oxygen cells a little bit better than if you were just training at a sea level. So when you come up, you'll feel it, you know. I know that there's times where I spent a prolonged amount of time at a lower elevation, came up and thought, holy cow.
It makes a difference. Well, not a lot of action. 20 seconds left, first round. Need to see a little more.
Yeah, we've seen some flurries. Oh, there's a shot right on the edge of the mat with short time. Hopefully he can harvest this leg and pull it in.
Nothing
7
yet.
Seconds. Going to keep trying to reach for it. Look at the flexibility here. That's something special. One thing that you'll see in Division I is the flexibility. Saves you from a lot of takedowns. That's how great it is.
Saves you from a lot of injuries, too. That's a good job for Stanford to not let that thing go in a direction other than the one he wants.
Red defers to green for the second round.
No score. Utah Valley down. Now green, now red.
Nice job exploding up, gets to his feet. Cardinal jumping out. Look for some defense here. Meyer will look to climb up that leg to the next hip, collect the legs and go out of bounds. Cusmanson did a good job jumping up, getting up out.
I like this official.
Again, right up to his feet. Nice job by Cusmanson.
Hips
again, he's fighting hips. You know, he did a good job. He threw pushed the hands down and away without actually securing a hand control. And that was the difference between him getting away and not. He just pushed the hands down and he almost broke free. And Meyer was actually able to just recapture and hold on to him as they went out of bounds.
All right, he's up and out this time. Here we go.
Again, right up to his feet.
A roll, minus recover.
He's pretty high up there on his hips. His hips are high. I look for Cusmanson to keep his butt high, get up even in a tripod position and shake him off the top, block out that other leg from coming into full leg, double leg ride.
Not much progression. This could end in a stalemate.
Notice how Meyer is even using his feet as hooks to as little hands to extend and stretch Cusmanson out.
Now he's got to go. A lot of hanging on. There's a stalemate.
That's good. That's good for Chase. He's done a decent job getting right up to his feet. A fresh start allows him to just reset and get going again.
Seems like the pace of this match is like
Wisconsin.
It's the old vinyl turntable. There we go. There's one. It'll be one. There's one. Nice call. It's the old turntable.
Just
45,
so
33, 45, 78. It's like we got a 33.
We got a 33 and a third.
But that was a good flurry there. There was some action.
Yeah.
Let's get 45 going here.
Yeah. Let's turn
Ramp
that up.
It up, boys.
Here we go. Let's get these hands going.
24 seconds, second round.
Kyle Meyer was able to accumulate a minute 20 riding time. That may be a factor in this match as we go into the third period with 12 seconds left.
Is Utah Valley shooting?
You know, in this match, they've been pretty head-to-head as far as fighting for position. Not a lot of shots on either guy's part.
2 minutes remaining. Choice is Stanford. He's probably going to go into the down position.
And we'll look to at least accumulate a little bit of riding time here to knock off that riding time point that Stanford's Kyle Meyer has accumulated.
He needs to grind 20, 21 actually. That'll make it a non-factor. Or let's just turn him and pin him. We could do that.
Yeah, that looks good.
That's a tough.
He's got a change here. See, right here is where your chain comes into play.
Yep,
if you hang there, you're not going to be able to hang on to the entire leg with just one bicep, one arm. So he scores a quick escape, 1:06 remaining still in the riding time with 1:37 in the match. Let's see what Chase can do. He's got to score a takedown.
We need a takedown. 6 seconds right now. Stanford's leading with the riding time advantage, so it's a 2-1 match, and Utah Valley needs a takedown, and you got 1:20 to do it. Plenty of time. Got to get active, though. Quit looking at the clock.
Oh, a little elbow pass. Dropped his level with the elbow pass. Didn't quite get a good shot. Chase has got to get going. It's 1 minute left in the match. 1:02. Shot again.
Uh-oh.
It's pretty deep.
See
what Chase can do as far as sitting back. He's sitting for a switch here.
54 seconds remaining.
It's tough to do this here with his head in the way.
And he's long. He stopped it. I think it's a good call. That's not a bad call. 9 times out of 10, you're not going to get there. You got to go through this guy's head. That wasn't a bad call. Protecting wrestlers is always a good call.
Always. Referees will always do that. They'll look to the safety of the wrestler first, and then the rules fall in there. And
37 seconds remaining. We need a takedown. Right now, Stanford's going to win this. The referee score. There's a shot. Come on, get active. Twenty seconds.
Straight on shot like that. It's
we got 14 seconds. We got to get
something
going
to try and score something off that.
Why are we grabbing the head? I don't get that. Nah, he won't get that. He's got that leg. I don't get that. Why did we tie up? Why are we not moving?
Well, and the unfortunate thing is we're tying up. That kind of prohibits us from getting out around and getting some angles unless we're going to really start moving and pulling, and there wasn't so much of that, and there's some straight-on shots. So, you know, Chase did a good job. Could have done better. We would like to end up on the other end of that.
Well, Utah Valley, that one goes Stanford's way. We'll be right back. You're watching Division I Wrestling. Don't go away.
I'm Sylvia Bentley, an anthropology student at UVU studying ancient Peru, and this is my classroom. At UVU, I'm graduating with a diploma and a resume.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
You are at the PE building, and Utah Valley welcomes Pac-12 action. We like it when the Pac-12 comes to visit.
We do. We get great competition. We love the Pac-12. But something to keep in mind, in the past 2 years, UVU has not fallen against a Pac-12 opponent. We're looking to keep that one alive tonight for sure. We got a close match. We are 11. Our guest, 6.
And we have been through 5. We're halfway. We've been through 5 matches. Now we're getting into the big guys. And I look to see us do some good things. Abner Cook, I think Abner is on the verge of really putting some things together. And he is going to wrestle Brett Bamba, one of their better.
Yeah.
This could be a tough one. Good assignment. Be a big win if Abner can make this one work for us.
This is a key matchup tonight. Abner's done very well in dual competition this year. Brent Bogg back coming at us, a junior from Council Bluff, Iowa. We know those Iowa guys, they're pretty dang tough.
Yep.
So this will be a good match.
Abner out of Idaho, solid wrestler. Great part of the team here, and here we go.
Snap down right away.
Action at 165 pounds. Again, battling for that position, trying to control the arms.
A Russian position back to just fight with these hands. Keep your neck kinked up. Extend your neck, you lose some power. Push and pull and get that neck tired. That's where a lot of other things start coming into play. Start moving them easier. Start snapping them down easier. For that underhook position too. A lot of offense come out of there. Abner resets, here we go. Got a minute 15 off this first period. Nice double leg. Nice movement, penetrated in, there was no finish. No explosion off of that. Was able to grab the back of the knees, but no pull through or push through. Front headlock here again. This can be really tiring for an opponent. Keep that head down and here we go. Resetting again. Oh, snap down there.
How important is first takedown?
You know, especially when you get into Division I, many matches, especially against tough opponents, are decided by 1-2 points. Being the first one to go on the board is very, very important. Changes the whole tone of the match.
Nice
changes how
shot.
You changes how you may wrestle the next few matches. There is such thing as wrestling to secure some time, to accumulate riding time, and then there's wrestling to catch back up. And you know how the first round ends up. First points, that dictates how you're going to wrestle the rest of the match.
So far, we're seeing a lot of this guy. Seeing where your weaknesses are, where your strengths might be.
Well, I felt like our last match with Chase and Kyle Meyer, I felt that it was similar to that. It was just filling each other out for a lot of the match. And then, as you can see, that match was decided by 1 point. And we'd rather not that. We'd rather UVU step up out here, scoring some big points in the first round, some near fall.
We had opportunity, too. We had plenty of time, and we could have got the takedown. That didn't happen. We'll have to ask Coach about that. Oh, ran out of time. 3 minutes are gone. Green's got choice. He's deferring it over. Stanford's going to go down on the mat. No score. Utah Valley holding on to a 5-point dual lead halfway through the game. Zabrin got to work that turn, got to work a lift, getting back to the mat, which he did. Stanford immediately back up. Nice job, nice scramble there. Now into a single leg. Got to improve that situation. Stanford doing a good job making us work to counter that.
Yeah, well, both guys are wrestling one of the chain ring in. I thought it was chain wrestling.
Abner's
got a nice cradle.
Got his head
He's
close to the knee.
This
if
up.
He can lock that up, that might work well for us.
This is kind of a weird angle to have a lockup because you're thinking, which way do I want to take this? And where a guy is real flexible like this, he's actually
strong there. Yeah. He's strong there too.
That's and you see that lock, it gets shifted from up by his ear, clear down to his knee, and that's actually really hard to defend that.
Wow, that was interesting.
We got a scramble situation here. It was a single leg. Abner steps over the top, now he's in a drape position. And it's going to be a scramble. Abner's going to seek to just maybe just roll him right out. I don't know, we're going to stay in bounds, but Abner's got to keep his hips up. Got to be tough right here. Some guys look to just get a stalemate. But it gets tough when you really get start getting extended when he can isolate that one hip.
In Division One, as long as we're in bounds, we're going.
Abner's feeling, you know, he's
no
rolling
points,
him up on his
no
neck.
No points
hopefully.
Yet. No points yet. No control. There it is. That was the release, and that's two for red. That's a three-point swing for Stanford. Now we gotta step it up. Out of bounds, new start. Ah, interesting. We pick up one on an illegal move. Stanford dropped into a hit scissor.
We step.
So we did a hit scissor.
We did a hit scissor. Was he, I wonder if, it, you know, when they were in that drape position, I think that's where that came from.
It fell there.
So I think he was holding an illegal hold. Until we went out of bounds, that's when he awarded the point. So it wasn't at that moment, it had happened a little earlier. So, ooh, nice reversal here.
Nice.
To a shoulder hug. Hopefully, we get a shoulder. Ooh. No near fall there, but a good reversal with good amount of time.
Excellent.
That was great for Abner.
That
very,
was
very
excellent
good.
Excellent right there. 2 minutes.
Third round.
Here we go. Abner's got choice. What the coach is saying.
Here we go. This is just a good switch from a leg right position. He grabs onto the head. He gets his hips high. He lets go of the head. Swings right around for a reversal. Right there had an opportunity for a shoulder hug position too. Hips weren't tight enough to put enough pressure on.
That was excellent motion right there.
Again, we're into the leg right position here. Maybe Abner can turn that switch again. He's going to back up over this leg. Look to extend him. Reach him back to try and pull that hip. But most of the time, I would always say never, ever, ever reach back. But
well, Stanford's doing a good job. Got us in trouble here. This leg, this arm, we got to get this out. He gets this bar going or turned, and that doesn't bode well for us. Now he's going to try and work that into an arm bar. Abner does a good job fighting out of that. That's a tough fight to be down there trying to get your arms back under control. You.
Those arms
and
the
hips
leg,
come up,
that
leg comes
rides.
In.
Abner knows that's coming.
Let's
hope that he sees that coming.
Got to stomp that yard. 106 remaining. We need to score.
I'm going to look this way. Our top guy, Brent Bombeck, doing a good job of just controlling. He knows Abner's got some good hips, so he secures that other leg, that other ankle, where he can't really swing his hips out around. Again, the leg right comes in. And he's, again, locking up on that leg. Tilt positions. Oh, right here, he's going to push this down and away. He's going to really extend this. Abner's going to look to just pin his hips down to the mat and push the leg away. Maybe throw that out and start moving right here.
If 27 seconds, if Abner could get behind that leg and make it work, don't reach up too high. Come on, go. 15, coming up on 15.
Short time here. Bomb back up by 2 points. Short time. See if Abner can pull something
and
out.
And riding time. We need a big move right here. 10 seconds.
I'm feeling that as I watch. Looks like some of these Stanford guys are tired. Well, ball back here. He's huffing pretty hard.
And they're on their way to wrestle Boise State.
11-9. Wolverines lead after 6 hours.
I thought Abner was battling in there, but it seems like Abner's just on the verge of really making something take place, that when it starts to really happen and he's consistent and he's comfortable and he's confident, I think Abner's going to be a great addition.
I agree. We're here at Utah Valley. We're at Utah Valley. Keep with us. Got some great wrestling coming right up.
I'm Sylvia Bentley, an anthropology student at UVU studying ancient Peru, and this is my classroom. At UVU, I'm graduating with a diploma and a resume.
Bus pass, $5. UVU t-shirt so you can impress the ladies, $25. iPod Nano, $120. A degree from UVU so you can afford your own car someday. Priceless. For everything else, there's student loans.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
When Utah Valley became a Division I program and we brought wrestling here, and we had a long road to go because we had 6 years before we could begin to compete on a national level, this is huge to see a coach's poll that puts two of our guys close to that top 20 position.
Well, it is, and Jade and Josh have both wrestled very well, placing in prestigious tournaments. You got to give your hat off to each of them. Hard work equals a little bit of payoff, a little bit of recognition.
So if we can continue to knock at that door, and as Coach says, I go back to what Coach says, we've got to become confident knowing that we can not only wrestle with these guys, but we can also beat these guys. Abner's on the verge of that. I think Monty's doing a good job for us to become comfortable so that we can make our statement, because if you're not able to beat those top 30 and top 20 and top 10 guys, then when you get to the big tournaments, you got to really tough road to come.
Exactly.
And that's what we're trying to do. So we're good. We've come a long way. We're still a young program. We've only been able to recruit with that enticement of a national championship. That's a big, big factor because of that 6 years when we weren't able to do that. And that's just part of the process of going from a community college to a Division I program. So we've done it. We're in good shape. We're coming along. But I like where we're at. We're just, you know, got to continue. Success takes time, it takes work, it takes effort.
Well, when you talk about recruiting last year, we're talking last year, our recruiting class coming in 2012 was ranked in the top 15 in the nation recruiting class. That means something this year. We've already had some really, really fantastic talent. And we're not just talking Utah talent.
Yeah.
We're capturing that. Yeah. We're getting some really fantastic kids from out of state as well.
So the program is solid. We need to win this match. We got six down and four to go. Monty Schmalhaus, nice
shot
to a single. Monty's a good tough wrestler out of Tooele, Utah.
Looking to trip it down.
There's
nice
two
job
right there.
Two. And again, he's immediately into that ride. Some of these guys on the team, you can tell that they've been putting some development into really grinding on a guy. When I say grinding, I mean you're constantly pressuring him. Pressure on his head, pressure on his neck, pressure on his hands, making sure he's doesn't have a lot of places to go.
Well,
you got to believe
that Monty and a couple of these guys coming up want to come up big, not just win the match, but win it with a fall, well, with a major.
Yeah, we're hoping for that here. Again, Monty Schmalhaus taking on Thomas Kimbrell. For Kimbrell's a freshman, Schmalhaus got a little seniority on him.
They're again working into that, controlling that leg, trying to make the hip turn so I can then get the shoulders to the mat.
When you look at a leg ride, a good leg ride, and Monty's doing a good job of this, opponent's Stanford opponent's leg up off the mat. That means you got good hip pressure. Your hips totally covering his hips. That's some good indicators that a leg ride is good. Your pressure's not up.
He's working into that bar. Now he's going to run it, step off, and make it go. It's really solid, really tight. If he gets it turned, it'll be good. Going to come back the other way. Kimbrell's doing a good job keeping his hips down.
No, I don't know if I agree with that.
We'll get it back again.
Yeah, we'll get it. I mean, Monty, you can see this wrist ride to a half, back to a bar arm series. I mean, he's got something really special going on here. We'll look to get back at it.
I don't think that was a bad call. That pressure was going forward. You just want every call to go our way, don't you?
I always look for that. I'm biased. I got to be true to my school.
There you go.
Again, he pulls him down to this kind of crab ride, looking for a shoulder hug.
There's a lot of pressure there. Hips under control.
Goes to a power half.
We're going to score some points here. We're going to score some here. Well, you got the count going. There's one, two. There's three. And he's turning and time runs out. Oh, 2 point. Near fall. Got 3 points. Three counts.
Darn, that was a little too late. We'll look for Monty to turn that back on. He's good at that. He is good in that leg ride position.
We've had him in trouble twice in the first round. Let's see what happens in the second. Choice goes green. Monty's going to take the down position. Monty's killer with that. Gets that hip bound. Comes up on top.
He's really developed his top position. Make it very, very difficult to ride.
Now here again, Stanford's got to put him down. Monty's got his hips up, working on hand control right now. Got one under control. There's the other.
He just let him go.
There's one. Okay, we're looking good. We've had him in trouble twice. We got riding time. We got a 5-point lead. Now let's get that fall. 1:35 remaining, second round.
I think we look for Monty. Let's hope he extends this lead. I think we got a real chance to score some bonus points here.
As guys get bigger, more size, more strength, are they able to get the same kind of motions that we want to see, that you see out of the smaller guys?
Well, I'll tell you, Anna, I think especially in a Division I, I think sometimes there's quite a few weight classes in high school where you could get a good big guy that maybe he doesn't move as well, but as you get to the upper echelons of wrestling and you're competing at a high level, we go out of bounds here. You gotta have almost all your eggs in a basket, all your ducks in a row. And what I mean by that is, your training and your technique is good, your shape is good, your quickness and your athleticism is usually your top notch. And so, I don't even if the biggest guys, you still see him moving decently well. Thomas Kimbrell in on a decent shot. Monty's looking here to just scramble. Let's see if referee here what he wants to call out of this. Monty's doing a good job, especially his hips are really falling off.
As long as there's improvement, the referee will let it continue to go. Right now, we've still got that leg. And that's a safety call. Anytime the knee goes outside of the range of motion or outside of the column of the body, that's where Stanford's knee was. I think Monty was helping it a little bit.
I think so too, and something that's great. We were able to ward that off with short time. I think that would have been bad for us had we given that up with just such short time left.
All right, 2 minutes remaining. Stanford wants to go neutral. And the official needs something taken care of. Looks like a headgear or something's a little out of whack. And or maybe a little blood. They're going to take care of it. As we go to the side, the coaches attend. The young wrestlers that are watching, what is it that's key to developing the ability to be a Division I wrestler? What does it take? What do you have to be doing?
I tell a young wrestler, wrestle all year. There is plenty of opportunity for a wrestler, and it's tough. Here's our next five matches. South Dakota State, we're going up there. We're doing a little doubleheader, the 6th and the 8th of February, North Dakota State and South Dakota State. Then we're going over to Boise, another Pac-12 school. Going to take them on, see if we can't keep this victory going, and then we'll be back home for Air Force.
Air Force here will be a fun one. We've got the high school state championships going on over in the big auditorium, and be a big house, it'll be full, it'll be fun.
But going back to what you had asked me about, you know, getting into it, there's a lot
nice
of sports.
Shot by Monty.
Nice
single
shot.
Leg. Good lift to a double, nice finish. 1 foot in, 2 points.
There's a lot of sports you can play. And I, when I say you got to wrestle all year, there's just opportunity to really take advantage of developing yourself throughout the year. You got to start looking to that. I would say getting your getting reps in. If you're thinking of your technique and what really works at higher levels, you got to practice that over and over and over again. I can guarantee you that's a huge part of what Utah Valley does is there's technique practice, and then there's practice where you're actually doing a lot of live wrestling. But technique is very, very important to drilling practice, where maybe all you do is just drill the same move for an hour to 2 hours at a time.
How much do you gain from wrestling in the other styles, freestyle and Greco?
I'll tell you, it gives you a good balance in many positions. You got to be good on your feet in freestyle. You also got to have great hips and a great base to wrestle Greco-Roman in freestyle wrestling. So they bode well for each other. I think a good freestyle wrestler makes a good collegiate wrestler, and vice versa. Mat time is important.
Schmalhaus with 46 seconds remaining, comfortably in charge. 7 points. To zero with riding time gives us a major decision here. That'll help the cat tally. And now we're trying to get that turn. 35 seconds left.
We got time. I think we got time to
and there's a stalemate.
Darn it. We do. We got time to make something happen, I believe.
30 seconds. Had him in trouble twice. Need one more.
Tight on top, tight. Look to lift and return him to the mat. We got to ride him tough. We want to score this bonus point, including here.
Yeah, hold the major decision. 12 seconds. Work that, use your leg. Coach is yelling. Nice job. Stanford dove for the head. That didn't happen. 1 second left. There it is. There's a major for us. That'll score 14 points. Monty does his job. We sent him to the mat. He brought back a victory. And that's a good job by Monty Schmalhaus out of Tooele, Utah. You're watching Division I Wrestling here in the PE building on the campus of Utah Valley University. Pac-12 versus WWC. And we will be back.
Dawn is breaking at Utah Valley University. 33,000 students are descending on campus. What are they after? Knowledge? Opportunity? They might be pursuing an MBA, an automotive certificate, or a bachelor's degree in philosophy. But despite their different paths, they share a common understanding.
Born on the beach, so the coast inspires how we prepare everything from our crisp salads to our irresistible burritos. And with more fresh sauces and salsas to choose from, meals at Costa Vida are truly a custom experience. Costa Vida, the coast is calling.
Anthropology student at UVU, and this is my classroom. At UVU, I'm sharpening my mind and my skills.
Thank you. I'm Patty Garcia, a geology student at UVU, and this is Engaged Learning. At UVU, I'm learning by doing.
Well, we've talked about the growth. We've talked about the growth of the program. We've talked about the quality of the recruits. Now let's talk about our coaches, Greg Williams, and now we've added this year. There he is, the man, Mr. Justin Reese,
the Taylorsville. Man beast.
Taylorsville, Utah product, three-time state champion in Utah. He just joins us after being at the top of the game in America, our best Olympic Greco-Roman wrestler.
10 times.
World medalist. This guy is the real deal, and he is helping us a lot with the big guys.
Doing a great job.
Getting in the room with them, battling with them, and teaching them how to have motion and have great, great throw, great hips, that Greco influence. All-American at Nebraska. Just a great, great addition to the staff. And, of course, the thing I always love is the fact that they're back together again. Greg was his mentor and coach when he was a national champion in high school and was three-time state champion.
Well, yeah.
So now he's done his international career. He's back ready to contribute back to the culture of Utah wrestling and Utah coaching. So he's a real blessing to us, along with Kane and, of course, Greg.
A lot of wrestlers that ended up wrestling for Greg were fortunate enough that he was our mentor and coach as we grew up, and I'm one of those. I knew Greg was a great coach from a young age, but when he came to the university, I thought it was very fitting. And he's got guys that have come back to wrestle with him, and now he even gets one of his wrestlers that has come back to coach with him. So it's pretty fitting. We have two world-class coaches, Rakeen and Justin, do a great job. Justin really cares about these guys, not just about their wrestling development. He cares about them being good young men and good students, and you can see that in his training. Justin does a lot with Little League and younger kids too.
We're at 184 pounds. Derek Thomas, a redshirt freshman from Layton High School in Utah. His opponent, Ryan Davies, also a freshman. And this should be a good one. Derek's a great talent. Developing, learning what it's like at the Division I level, but he's a talent. I've always liked him. Quick, good stuff, able to make things work. Yep, there's a nice job into that underhook.
He's up from the Davis County area, and really, really hardworking kid. Loves the sport and loves to compete. So he put it out. He'll put it all out there.
That's a nice
shot.
Very nice.
Nice elbow pass, and the leg's right there. He grabs a double leg, swings those legs together, and picks it up, puts him down. Nice job by Derek.
As he lifts, he turned to Matt.
We're out right here by the booth. We're 56 seconds left in this first period. Put a lot of pressure on. Again, this ride to a half Nelson to a crab ride position being worked by a lot of UVU's guys.
He'll cut him. He'll let him go.
36 seconds left.
Boom.
Let's see if he can turn this up.
See, do I know my guys?
Well, you can see it. I think it shows a little bit of youth. Oh my, that was a nice foot sweep.
Wow, that was great.
That was amazing. What a great foot sweep by Derek Thomas. Felt the pressure, got a pull, got light on his. Our Stanford Ryan Davies got light on his foot and just swept it out.
I told you he's always been my guy. Huh?
You did.
Okay.
Hard working.
Put him back down right at 5. We got 5 seconds to go on this one. 2 takedowns, looking for a cheap. Can't quite get there, we run out of time. That's a good first round, good 3 minutes. 4 points. And we've got, looks like a blood time. For
blood time out here.
Take care of the mat, take care of things. That was good. I like how relaxed we are. Look at this sweep. Here it is on the replay.
He goes to a...
This is the lift.
He goes to a lift here. Returning back right
down.
Back down. Heavy up on top. Not letting him off for that last 5 seconds.
He works in that cheap 2-on-1 underneath. Now he's doing a lift. Look at his left leg. Try to lift the hip. turn the hip. He's got him in criteria, the 45-degree angle, had him in criteria, and then time ran out. So we'll get him there once. Hopefully we can get him there again.
Derek ran over to Greg, and Greg had a smile on his face for Derek. Greg is a fantastic at a foot sweep, so I'm thinking he's going, hey, props. Yeah. Props for that foot sweep, Derek.
Nice one.
I saw that.
Yeah, totally took Stanford out of his balance and out of his position.
I remember when Greg used to coach us, you know, he was younger, he wrestled with us more, and so he would literally say, okay, I won't even shoot on you. And he would literally foot sweep us for just half an hour straight. Just take you by a foot sweep.
Take you off your feet doing that. All right, here again, riding position. Derek's trying to work into that tight hips where he can come into a high half, or now he's got a 2-on-1, might want to try that cheap twilt. There it goes. Now he jumps into a high half. Now if he can get free and run that to the right, he's trying to work that. Stanford's doing a good job of straightening up, not letting that half Nelson work, taking the pressure away.
You can see a lot of a wrestler, where they're at, where their mind's at, physically they're at, but where their head is at. If their head is laying on the mat, you know that they're just subsiding. They're just kind of hanging on. And
we're putting a lot of pressure. There's always that part of it, too. Derek's going to score some near fall here in a second. He's got a minute and five, second round.
He's going from 4-1. Side to side. He's doing a good job at taking whatever comes, just chain wrestling from move to move to move.
Nice throw. Wow. Nice throw across. That was patented by Mr. Kale Sanderson. That was his big deal. Get that heavy half, roll you across, and as you come across, use that throw across the body to transition into that half and then put him into trouble. Sanderson made that thing look like...
Oh, made it look easy.
Easy.
He's heavy again. Scoop that arm up, looking for a bar arm on that left-hand side. See if he pulls it out, sinks it in.
Team score 15 for Utah, 9. And there is a warning.
Utah Valley.
Greg goes, what?
Yes.
Just got to work it. Got to improve it. Of course, the question is, are we overpowering Stanford? Because he's down pretty flat. I haven't seen him build much of a base.
And that's where I kind of disagree with that call again. Maybe I'm biased, but when you got an opponent that is literally lays his head, and we've gone side to side to side, and we've had turning opportunities. No turns yet, but turning opportunities. It's hard for me to say, top guy is stalling.
Well, the bottom guy's got to be coming up. He's got to be getting his hips up or working to get his hips up. And if we're overpowering, we're not stalling. We're overpowering. There's a difference there. So, I don't know. It was an instant call. No big deal. It was a warning. 2 seconds and we're done with round two. It was a warning, but it was an instant call. Greg's saying, let's get at it. We need to be up bigger by this. So get down position. Coach Williams says, take that down position. Let's get up and out. As we begin the round, number three, we have riding time and a 4-1 lead on the score. Nice job. Nice jump right up. And Stanford's going to hang there a while, trying to make something work. Hadn't been able to do it. Derek's going to move, fighting hands. That doesn't go. Look at how athletic he is. Slides outside, keeps his balance, totally on his feet.
Yeah, Stanford coach waving his guy on. Let's keep going, he says.
All right, here we go. We're coming up and out. Hips up.
A little high there.
Yeah, but what is... There's a warning. He'll do that once. He'll do that one once. Potential or a... Tirapelli's cheering over the corner saying, come on, man. Let this thing work.
When you jump up like that and without a lot of action, the ref's going to say, you're stalling.
That's running him out. There we go. That's a good job. Turn that hip down hard, Derek. He's got to break the grip. And here Here's an interesting call. Stalemate. That's an interesting call.
Very interesting. They're both inbounds by far. That's a shot position.
That's almost like
somebody being on top. You can't. That's.
It's almost like he's given two advantages. You can go a warning. You can go a stalemate once. If you go twice, we're stalling.
Okay, here we go.
Come on, Derek.
He's going to look to push this leg down and away. He's going to push this leg down and away.
There's a nice turn, guys. Hips turn.
Got his hips high. He's got to get.
He's
got to get
Stanford in trouble.
Oh, that's.
Now Stanford cannot figure four that leg. There it is. Oh, come on, man. How is that not a figure four? 38 seconds we go. And we got the cat calls. Everybody wants some kind of warning. Not much going on there.
Well, we got warned.
Stalemate again.
We got warned for the same type of thing, but less, in my opinion.
That's interesting. That's interesting.
Let's look for Derek to fire up out of here.
27 seconds. Come on, Derek.
Not as much opportunity for leg red to come in.
Here we go. Third round. Get out of there. Nice job to his feet. Nice job on the hands.
This is just hanging.
Nice job away. There it is. 18 seconds. There's time. There's time for a takedown.
He's looking to get a takedown. Score up a major decision here.
Pummel inside. Be smart.
Got 10 seconds to score something here.
Boom. Oh, nice. Nice. Keep it in.
Nice.
Two. That away. That away. Good hips. Good solid stance. Good hips. Didn't let himself get pulled over there. 2.2 remaining. We got another major coming at us here, too. Don't let him away. 2 seconds, Derek. Oh, it won't be. It'll be a 7-point win.
We got riding time, too.
Seven.
Oh, that's right. He got that escape. Darn it.
Well, that's
narrowly
all right. We'll
it.
Take that. We'll take a win. That's a W. That adds 3. 15 to 9.
Very
18
nice.
To 9.
Here's this.
Look at this
nice replay here.
Look at how solid he stays in his position. Just dumps him right to his back. Hips in, foot stays in. That's a good takedown. That's just strong position. Nice job. Well, we're looking good. We got 2 matches to go. 18-9. We're leading. Utah Valley out in front. Don't go away. There's two big guys to go. We'll be back. Division I Wrestling.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
Dawn is breaking at Utah Valley University. 33,000 students are descending on campus. What are they after? Knowledge? Opportunity? They might be pursuing an MBA, an automotive certificate, or a bachelor's degree in philosophy. But despite their different paths, they share a common understanding.
I'm Joe Luce, an anthropology student at UVU, and this is my classroom. At UVU, I'm sharpening my mind and my skills.
Patty Garcia, a geology student at UVU, and this is Engaged Learning. At UVU, I'm learning by doing.
Two matches remaining. It's Utah Valley versus Pac-12. Stanford University, we're at 197 pounds, and then the big men. Two remaining matches, wrestling for Stanford, Michael Sochka, and his opponent from Utah Valley, the Las Vegas connection, Mr. David Prieto.
Yeah, David got mad at me last week. He said, Sam, why did you call me small? And I was, our last broadcast, he wrestled Arizona State. The Arizona wrestler was very, very
big.
Tall. He was a tall wrestler. And David said, don't ever call him small again. So I got to say, he is a beast.
He's a beast, and he's
a powerful, huge beast. So I give props to David. David's a lot of fun. He's a good part of a team, a good team player. He adds to the camaraderie. I got to give it up to him. He works well with a lot of the other wrestlers.
I've always been impressed with his athleticism for his size. And I think he's still growing into the size. Does he have, I mean, where is he when he's not trying to cut weight?
You know, he gets up, you know, he's wrestling 197. He trains really hard. For a long time, I was training with these guys, and so I got to see day in and day out. And he was always one that really impressed me as we were in the weight room training, getting explosive. He was very explosive, very, very strong, and impressed at his work ethic.
He has that athletic ability to do just fun things that are, you know, just that explosive, get in, make a shot.
And, you know, it makes it fun to watch wrestlers like that. You know, he's younger, he's developing, and so we'll look for him to develop on that this year and be ready next year and look to make some big impacts. So
he's doing a nice job keeping pressure on Stanford's head. Sochka's being bent over quite a bit. There he is, battling in, trying to get to that. I like the attitude. I like Prieto's coming out to get at it a little bit. I like that. 18-9 is the team score with two matches remaining in favor of Utah Valley. And there's a nice little shot just at the edge. Little double leg. Nothing comes of it. Prieto comes out to center up.
Look to have David keep going with this pressure. He's doing a good job. He's changing. You know, I say this on top. I say it on bottom. I say it on our feet. If you have a tie-up, if you have a move, and you're static in that move, and you're not moving to something else, or it's not progressing, then you're going to be in trouble. You're in danger of being scored on. You're in danger of exposing yourself. And, you know, David's doing a good job. Nice single leg here.
Nice pickup, nice elevation. Got good control there.
Sweep that down.
Sweep. Not yet. Get the double. Get it.
You can lift this back up. Pull it in. He's jumping out. So let's see. Gonna pull it all
good
the way job. Back in the middle. Nice
That's
job, I think.
Good job, David.
He's got to keep moving it, though. Again, even right here, he's got to keep moving.
There
he
goes. Good
takedown. Even on our feet, that's a good position to illustrate my point. Even if we're on our feet and I got a guy's leg and I have it elevated up, if I'm standing there, he's going to be in a better position to start defending and jumping out of it.
Stanford comes up and out. We got 10 seconds remaining. 2-1. Score in favor of Prieto of Utah Valley.
A short time here.
That's a good start. Looks like we clocked heads in the middle of that thing. Green's choice, we're gonna go neutral. So what started that last flurry? What I liked early on was David was keeping really good pressure on his head. Now it's like he's kind of catching breath a little bit.
Yeah. Burned a lot of gas there, being real active. You know, again, right here, that's a perfect example. You hang out and over and under, you got to be pretty good at throwing if you're going to hang out there. I say you got to keep moving. On the edge of the mat, darn it,
don't shoot there, don't give
shoot
that
on the edge, but we're out of bounds. He's not going to give that takedown. On the edge, he dove in for a shot. not a huge setup. Luckily came out with no takedowns there.
There's some danger there for a moment because Stanford turned that around pretty good. He was in the place, but he didn't get it finished. Remember, three components of a shot: the setup, the shot itself, and the finish. All three are imperative. All three have to take place. Predator doing a nice job of creating pressure, wearing him down. Nice elbow pass, staying away. Stanford in with a second shot to go out of bounds. Stanford coaching staff on the edge. They're going, well, I think they see him getting in trouble because he's getting so much pressure. Prieto is putting so much pressure on his head that he's keeping him down, and things are going to open up, especially as the match wears on. Both coaches up on the edge of the mat trying
nice
to tell him to stay
here.
Out of that. 29 seconds, second period.
Looking for that, digging for that underhook right here. And David's really pulling on that neck, looking to tire that out, start getting some moves. Not a shot there, short shot. Ooh, he locks it up. Ooh, locked it up.
Those are good changes.
Pole.
That's good physical stuff going on. It's just
change,
upper body.
Change, change, nice.
Good physical stuff, upper body, and we're out of time. There's round two going. Not much riding time, no big deal there. 2-1 score. Stanford taking the down position. Two to one score. This is a tight one. Although I think we're creating a little more pressure. That was
a quick start.
Yeah, it was.
Nice job.
All right, we're tied up. 2-2. Okay. No riding time. 2 points. 2 points. Even Steven. Now it comes down to tough conditioning and who can make that last finish. They're both going to try to get position for a
nice
shot.
Nice short shot. Nice short shot.
But it's about the finish.
No finish there. Got him to step. Got his hands to it. No finish.
Oh,
stopped
block.
Him there with a.
It's a good down block.
A down block. David's got a circle here. He's got a circle here.
Stanford came hard on both those shots.
Stanford's come twice and shot him out of bounds, and that makes me a little leery. A stall call maybe right on the horizon. David's got to, when he gets to that position, he's got to circle his butt, turn his butt to the inside of the mat, be the one that's aggressing that position.
Well, he can't be passive and sitting back on his heels too much, because those last two shots, they were right there.
Yeah, they were good. Those are good shots.
Were it not for David's strength and the down block that he was able to get together. He could have been in trouble. We're still
nice
tied up.
David's decent. He's getting an underhook to a head, you know, like a trapped headlock, and he's changing out of that well. Let's see if he can't turn something out of it.
42, 40 seconds remaining. Takedown's going to win this thing. Who's going to do it? Nice.
Wow. Great shot. Let's see what he
has.
He's
got to finish
it.
Got 25. Got to dig. 18. Now hang on. Don't let him get it. Keep it. There we go. 10 seconds. Dump it.
Short time here.
3-2. And no score, 1 minute. We're overtime, first time tonight. 1 minute.
Nice job by David on the shot. There was some good scrambling there, and he didn't give up anything. He stayed safe, and even at the end there.
That was a great shot. See how quick he was? That was just
astounding. He is quick, and he is athletic. But let's see if he can't turn that up. Get this takedown here in a sudden death overtime victory.
He's breathing deep. Got to get those lungs going. Get one more little scramble put together here with the right kind of motion. 40 seconds. Of course, we've taken all the risk. That was a big commitment. Well, no, Stammer's taking those two good shots, but not deep like that.
Digging that deep head trap. Without the trap.
25 seconds.
Short time here.
25.
Crowd really getting into it now.
15 seconds.
Cheering David on.
Need one, good one.
10 seconds. Another shot.
Stanford's backing out. And hold it tight. 2 seconds and we're done. 30 seconds.
2 30-second overtime.
Now we go 30 and 30. Both wrestlers get an opportunity to wrestle in position. 30 seconds. Wrestling continues. This is not sudden victory. This is a 30-second overtime, so it continues. Wrestling continues. We need to get the one here. Or the two, either. There you go. Get the hands.
Gotta just drop here.
Get the hands.
Get the hips down and drop.
He's driving us out. Come on. Come on, ref. Make the call. 14 seconds. They are wrestling pretty even. It's a pretty even match. Come on, David. 10 seconds. Get it done. Right here. Right here. And that's the end of that 30. Now we go the other way. We need a turn here. Or one and then two. One and then two. Here's where the conditioning comes in. Right now we're breathing hard. I got to find the strength to get this done. 30 seconds. Wrestle the entire 30 seconds. We're tied up. Second tiebreaker. There's one. Now we got to get a takedown. 25 seconds. 23. Got to force the action because Stanford's going to just stand there. 15.
Short time, 10 seconds.
10 seconds.
David's looking to get at it. Stanford's looking tired here.
Well, they both are. They're big men, 197-pound men. Stanford's going to run away. 5 seconds. Time.
Good heart, good match, both guys. I got to give it up to both
wrestling.
Of those guys.
That was good wrestling. It was tough stuff. Good job, both guys. Stanford wins that one by three. So 12, 18, 12. 18, 12. Last match. We're up six.
So we come down to this. And this is a good matchup. Fager's got a good matchup. And we got to be serious here. As long as Fager wins or does not get pinned, we're going to be in good shape. We're going to keep our Pac-12 win streak alive.
Yeah, we got to get it done. We got to wrestle it. So let's go. I like John. I like John's motion. I like his size.
John? John is Adam's brother.
Oh, easy Adam. I like Adam. I like John, too.
The Fager family is big in the state. John coaches at Layton High School in Davis County, Utah. Coached his brother, actually, to the state championship.
The thing I like about Adam is how well he moves, and he's growing into the weight. He's growing into the heavyweight.
Yep. So Adam's here looking to create some pressure, some changes out of that.
Well, he's a heady wrestler, too. He's wrestled a long time. That's a good job. That's a good job. Turn that corner. That's wrestling. Gotta like that. Adam's tough.
He is. He's grown. When you talk about growing into a heavyweight, up until this year, he had planned on wrestling 197 pounds, and
yeah.
The season, next week we got to be around this weight. Finally, gave him a drop date where you got to weigh, you got to be 120 or less by this date, and Adam just kept growing filling out, which is good. I think he could wrestle well at 100 at our heavyweight 285 pounds, and this will be interesting to see.
I like he's getting at it. I think he's trying. This is good. But he's got that athleticism. He can move like the big guy.
Yep.
And his brother, as that strength continues to develop for him.
Adam's brother, John, wrestled at Clarion University at a heavyweight. And, you know, his physique was similar. He was just huge, though, like a bodybuilder. That's the way I would describe it. A fantastic wrestler. So he passed some of those skills on to his brother. Nice shot there by Dan Shearer.
Got a minute. Press it back. Get the leg back. Straighten it out, Adam. It's a good job. He's turning into two for us. Keep pressing down. Keep that hip down.
So Adam's looking
stretch
to
him out.
Keep his hips into his head. Keep his head down by his hips. Extend his body by grabbing that back ankle and lifting up on the elbow.
Yep, there's a stalemate. We're still neutral.
40 seconds left in the first period here with the last match of the night, Adam Fager versus Dan Shearer.
Well, Fager's a redshirt sophomore and Shearer a junior. Age pretty close. Experience might be on the Stanford side. But I like Fager. I like his ability, his technique, his athleticism. And he brings a lot of good stuff, especially for the big guys. 17 seconds. First round in our final match tonight, Utah Valley versus Stanford.
You know, a lot of these matches here from about halfway point on have been a lot of deadlock, a lot of vying for position.
There's time. I liked his aggressive. I thought Adam came out here ready to wrestle. Let's see what could take place. So the fact that Justin Reese is on his feet now, so he's pulling for. Is he Adam's workout?
Big time.
Yeah.
Coach Reese, whatever Coach Reese says, Adam does, which is good. Adam's a good student for Coach Reese, and Coach Reese definitely has a lot of expertise and knowledge to add to this size weight class, being that he wrestled heavier weight class internationally.
Good job getting to his feet. Didn't finish it, though. Wasn't able to free the hands. No score, we're in the second round. Trying to stand. It doesn't look like he's doing much, but he's trying to get his weight under his hips, and Stanford's trying to keep all the weight on his shoulders that he can.
Yeah.
And he's working. That's a lot of work. It's an isometric experience. It'd be like sitting in your front room with the couch on you, trying to open the front door. It's kind of a challenge.
There's a move here. If you think of your hands being heavy up.
Here we go.
Oh, here he goes.
Now we're up. Get the hand separation. Oh, thank you. And there's a warning for Stanford. Walking us out.
But you slight, you know, you're talking about the weight being way up over his shoulders and his hands. There's something we call a knee slide, where you actually slide your knee right up underneath. You bring your hips underneath.
Which reverses the weight of that.
Yeah.
It reverses that pressure, that weight pressure. Well, now he's going to warn us.
Bottom.
Oh, what are we playing here? 30 seconds, second round. Same position, and it's a battle. It doesn't look like they're doing much, but it's an isometric. There's Adam up. There's Adam to his feet. Come on now, finish that. We got six. Push back down. Didn't work. All right, still no score. Round three. Shearer's going to take the down position.
Adam's decent on top. We'll see what he can turn out of this. Maybe put some pressure on. Can maybe get some turn, the turn or a pin here. Sure, does a good job. Gets up, chain wrestles to his feet.
Well, we got a minute 45. We need a takedown. That'll give us a win here. That'd be huge.
Schroeder through that second period accumulated a minute 51 riding
time.
That's
a good shot. In there deep. Nice job, Adam.
Nice hits. That's just a
nice. That's his F. Oh, there's two right there. That away. Come on. And one away. We're 2-2. That was a nice flurry. That's what I'm talking about. That's athletic right there. That's a good job.
I think that was actually good for Adam. Schreer has a minute 46 accumulated riding time, so he's actually up, my calculation, 3-2. That was a good job. We just got to let him go and get right back to our feet where we can score an additional takedown for
We still need a takedown. Takedown will win it. Got a minute.
56 seconds.
Now conditioning comes in. Who can dig down deep enough to put that energy together?
That flurry there, that just goes to show you some athleticism that Adam has. It's great.
I love it.
We've got to put something together, though. We got 30 seconds. Adam's got to turn this up.
Pick
We're
going
to make something
Adam.
Happen. Let's get him pulled. Nice
Nothing
pull.
Nothing to lose, buddy. Make it work, Mr. Fager. 22. Fifteen
seconds. Wow, not doing much to make it happen. Let's hope we put something together here without just diving in.
Take one. 6 seconds.
2-1.
Well,
darn it.
A 3-2 match is a victory for us because that gives them three. That's 15, 18, 15. 18, 15, your final score, Utah Valley. Once again, victorious.
We got it. That's a 5-0 against Pac-12 opponents, which we're stoked about. We appreciate Stanford coming into town. We're doing home and aways with them. It's a pleasure to have great competition coming to town. What are your thoughts?
Great victory requires great opponents. That's one thing that always matters, and that's a good job. There was some great wrestling, some great finishes. We ended up on top of the thing at 18 and 15 for the team score. But for us in our program at this point to come away with a solid victory against a quality team, always a good thing. Anytime we can represent well against the Pac-12, we love it. We'll be right back with the wrap. Don't go away.
Don't go away.